Dear students, today we are going to take study fourth chapter, that is planning. Planning is the fourth chapter. Before going to know the various aspects about this planning, we have to understand what is the weightage given for this chapter, that is Mars allocation. Dear students, in your exam from this chapter section A, you will get one question for 1 mark and one question from B section for 2 marks and one question from C section for 4 marks and no question will be asked from D section. And E section, there is a practical question which carries 5 marks, which may come or which may not come. But section A 1 mark, section B 2 marks and section C 4 marks, these are compulsory. That means 1 plus 2 plus 4, 7 marks are compulsory from this chapter. So the practical question may appear, may not appear in the question paper. So this is what about the Mars allocation about planning chapter. After knowing the weightage, now we are going to know or we are going to understand what do you mean by planning. So planning means what? We have already come to know in the very first chapter, that is nature and significance of management, that is functions of management, where we have studied planning, organizing, correct? Planning, organizing, stopping, directing, right? Controlling. We have come to know only the basic concept about planning, right? So in this chapter we are going to know meaning of planning, features of planning, importance of planning, that is advantages of planning, limitations of planning, types of planning, steps involved in planning, right? These are the synopsis which we are going to take study one by one in our incoming classes. In this class we are going to know meaning of planning and features of planning. These two concepts we are going to take study. So what is planning? Here the simple meaning given, planning is deciding in advance what to do and how to do. Yes, precisely if we try to understand, planning is a decision in advance. What to do, when to do, how to do, and who will do a particular task. Right? It is a process which involves thinking before doing. So whatever kind of organization, whether it is a large scale organization or medium scale organization, whether it is a trading organization or non-trading organization, planning is considered as the very first function of management. So without planning, no ideas are going to be executing. So in simple words, planning is nothing but thinking before doing. Because without proper plan, resources are not going to be effectively and efficiently utilizing. So with the help of proper plan, proper allocation of resources, if we implement the plan in a right way, in a right channel, no doubt organization is going to achieve its goals or its objectives. That is the reason why planning is a deciding in advance. why planning is going to do in advance, because it gives some ideas about what to do, either production, marketing, what is the task which we are going to do in future. At the same time, when to do, what is the time, what is the schedule, at the same time how to do. How to do means what are the different ways and means are there to do a particular task to achieve goals of the organization, and who will do a particular task. That means in an organization there are number of people who are working, but all people are not working the same kind of job, because there is a different background people who are working in the organization. That is, their qualifications are different, their knowledge is different. That is the reason why who is the right person to do the job. If there is an accounting task is there, and who has to handle this task? People who are expert in the field of accounting, in the commerce, accounting knowledge. BCom people, MCom people, or CA candidate people, they are the right people to do the task. So this is what the ideas are going to be generating in the very first step of the functions of the management. So it is a process which involves thinking before doing. So planning is considered what? It is intellectual thinking process. So every manager, every organization is going to think before what it is going to do. That is what planning. For planning is the very first function of management. This is what I already told you, which decides what to do to achieve the goals of the organization. So planning is always looking forward. With proper plan and its implementation, every organization is going to fulfill its goals or the objectives. After knowing the meaning, we are now going to study what are the different features of planning. Features of planning. So first feature here it is, planning focuses on achieving objectives. So objectives are nothing but these are the goals or these are the targets which are going to accomplish by the organization in future or after completion of a certain period of time. But it is not so easy without proper plan, and properly when that plan is implement, after that if the resources are utilizing in a proper channel, no doubt organization is able to achieving its objectives. So after setting up of the objectives, planning decides the methods, procedures and steps to be taken for achievement of set objectives. Planners also help and bring changes in the plan if things are not moving in the direction of objectives. For example, if an organization has the objective of manufacturing 2000 washing machines and in 1 month only 100 washing machines are manufactured, then changes are made in the plan to achieve the final objective. Right? Now the second one, that is, planning is a primary function of management. Planning is a primary function of management. Yes, that is why, as I already told you, planning is considered as the very first function of management. Then organizing, stopping, directing, controlling come. So planning is the first function to be performed by every manager. No other function can be executed by the manager without performing planning function because objectives are set up in planning and other functions depend on the objectives only, right? Planning always proceeds and remains at number one as compared to other functions like organizing, stopping, directing, controlling. Next, third one, planning is pervasive. That is, planning is required at all the levels of management, either top level, mid level, or lower level. So, it is not a function restricted to top level management only, but planning is done by managers at every level. That is, top level also plan, mid level also there is a plan, and lower level also there is a plan. With the help of proper plan, we are going to executing the things. So, formation of major plan and framing of overall policies is the task of top level management, whereas departmental managers form plan for their repetitive departments, means their respective departments. It is not repetitive, it is for their respective departments, like production department, marketing department, finance department, like that. And lower level managers make plans to support the overall objectives and to carry on day-to-day activities. This is what about the third one. Now, fourth one, planning is a continuous process. Planning is a continuous process. Because after making plans, also one has to be in touch with the changes in the changing environment. As we already studied in the third chapter, business environment always keeps on changing. So due to one or other factors, things are going to be changing. So in accordance with those changes, it is the responsibility of management of the organization to make a plan to face whatever changes are going to be taken place or whatever changes which are going to be take place in future. For that, we should have plan. So planning is a continuous process and which is not in static, which also go for changing due to change in business environment. That is what. And in the selection of one best way, so after making plans also, planners keeps making changes in the plans according to the requirement of the organization. For example, if the plan is made during the inflation period and during its execution there is a depression period, then planners have to make changes according to the condition prevailing in the environment, that is business environment. That means what plans we have made in the inflation, those plans are not going to be work out in the depression. So what is inflation? Inflation is a situation, or it is an economic situation wherein all the economic activities are performing at very high level. Investment more, production more, demand more, supply more, even profit is also more. But on the other hand, depression. So in the depression, it will be the reverse. What is that? Depression is a situation wherein economic activities are performing at poor level. That means low investment, less production, less supply, less demand, and less revenue. So in accordance with these changes, plan should be adjusted. So plan of inflation is different from the plan of depression. Now the next one, planning is futuristic. Planning is futuristic. Though we made plan today, but it is going to be implemented in future. It is not going to be implementing now only. Though we have made a plan today, but that plan is going to be apply or execute in future. For that purpose only, now we are going to come up with a particular plan. So planning is futuristic. That means planning always means looking ahead, or planning is a futuristic function. That I already told you, planning is nothing but looking forward, where we are right now and from this spot to where we have to go. And for that, what should be our ideas, what should be our strategies. This planning is never done for the past. All the managers try to make predictions and assumptions for future, and these predictions are made on the basis of past experiences of the manager and with the regular and intelligent scanning of the general environment. So management will come up with a plan, and that plan is going to implement in future. But to prepare a plan, there are some assumptions, there are some experiences, there are some situations, and there are some intelligent scanning of the general environment. On these basis, planning has been done, and which is going to be implementing in future. So these are what about features of planning. So in your exam, you may get question on this. What is that? To explain briefly any four features of planning. So take any four features of planning, write the points, main points, then 2-3 sentence explanation. If possible, give simple example. That's it. So this is what about features of planning. So next class we shall meet with different concept. Thank you.